Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and we will be talking about the joints covered in the spine, hip, and thigh session. Between the bodies of most vertebrae, not the immovable ones, but most vertebrae are going to be cartilaginous joints called intervertebral discs or IV discs. The size of these IV discs can differ quite significantly in terms of thickness throughout the vertebral column. And when looking superficially, such as we have here, here's a body of a vertebrae, you can see the spinous processes back here. And this region right here in between, and we're looking kind of in a lumbar region right here. So this region right here is an intervertebral disc. And when looking superficially, which is what we have here, you can only see the annulus fibrosus or the outer layer. So this is the IV disc, specifically that annulus fibrosus, so that outer protective layer. So if we just kind of draw and think about it, you have your annulus fibrosus in this more external region. And then inside, you also have that nucleus pulposus. And so that's going to be the internal portion of the intervertebral disc. And in a disc herniation, typically that nucleus pulposus will herniate through the annulus fibrosus. So kind of back here towards the posterior region or towards the intervertebral disc. So kind of posterior laterally is a common positioning in terms of herniation. Next, we get to the hip joint, and this is one of the major ball and socket joints, and it has some of the strongest ligaments of the body. We're not going to have you memorize all of them, but we do want you to understand which one is the largest and most important, and this is the iliofemoral ligament, which is shaded here in light blue. And this name tells you exactly where it attaches. It attaches from the ilium, so up in this region here, to the femur, so over in this region here. This is going to be that greater trochanter of the femur. And you can see the iliofemoral ligament much easier from an anterior view, which is what we have here. So this is an anterior view. I can see the pubic symphysis right here. I can see the coccyx. So this is an anterior view. But due to its size, you can actually see it from a posterior view as well. This is a posterior view. I can see some of the vertebral column right here. Here's that ischial tuberosity back here. And so you can see a little peak of that iliofemoral here as well. As mentioned, there are other ligaments associated with the hip joint that you are not responsible for identifying, but just for completeness sake, this is going to be the pubofemoral. As its name would suggest, it is going to attach from the pubis to the femur as well. Often the fibers become kind of intermingled with the iliofemoral. In the posterior view, you have the ischiofemoral. Here shaded in light orange, and this is going to be between the ischium and the femur. But again, it is this iliofemoral ligament that is the largest and the strongest and the one we want you to have an understanding of in terms of the hip joint. Excellent. So not too much here in terms of joints. We'll have quite a bit when we talk about the knee joint in the next session. But do feel free to reach out with any questions you may have, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.